Okay, here I am again, ladies and gentlemen, at the Can TV production here in Chicago. I'm here with a couple of real important cowgirls who's been a part of the cowgirl family, support me on the non-for-profit organization Stagecoach Production. My name is Tommie O. Penson, Jr. I'm the CEO and president of the operation. I have Julia White here on stage with me and Marguerite, two of the finest cowgirls you ever want to know and been around as long as I've been around with the things that we do. Julia, I start with Julia. What are some of the things we do when we operate and work with the kids out in the sector?
Well, we go into the community and we teach the children horsemanship. We've gone to different libraries. We've gone to a YMCA in Indiana. I don't know what part of Indiana was that.
Hammond,
Indiana. And we introduce our horses to the young ones. We tell them the different body parts. We tell them the different parts of the saddle and tell them what a lead rope is and just a lot of other things. And we find out a lot of the parents are so interesting and interested. And we just do a lot of things in the community. I'll let Marguerite M. tell you more about the Christmas parties and the toy donations and things that the regulators do. But we're just all about the children, education, and horsemanship.
We do have a lot of fun when we do these rodeos. Some of the cowboys have some time, ladies and gentlemen, a little drink or two, and like me, try to ride the event and either the horse run over them or fall off. But Marguerite, it's been inspirational with Julia in the cowboy world and the Stagecoach Production mentorship program. What are some of the other crazy things we do out there as the family of cowgirls and cowboys?
Well, most notably, the regulators, which is another non-for-profit horseback riding organization. We do a Christmas party each year, and we get toys from the public, and we deliver these toys to selected communities on horseback. We have a Santa Claus, we have a sheriff escort. The sheriff goes right up to the doorstep of the child's house, rings the doorbell. We make sure that it's the right family. And on horseback, we ride right up to the doorstep and deliver a bag of toys. We even have a Santa. And you know, it's sort of a parade. It's open to the public. You know, everyone is welcome to come along on this joyous day. And the kids, they are so surprised to see horseback riders and a Santa that comes right up and deliver toys. You know, so I think that's the best thing that we do.
Yes, that's all interesting. And we do encourage sometime that the public, when we do put on these rodeos, and some of the ladies out there that want to meet our cowgirls and cowboys, we do encourage and want to learn about horsemanship, that they come out and get a chance to get autographs from some of the participations that we do when we perform in rodeos. We also have something else that the Broken Arrow does. You want to expunge on that?
Julia?
Yes, Broken Arrow gives a nice gaming show every year at the South Shore Cultural Center. They also give a high noon ride where you can bring out your picnic baskets and make sure you bring your own chair or stool or whatever. Different families come. There's cowboys from the tri-state area, you know, from Wisconsin, Illinois, some as far as Kentucky, the Kentucky Hard Riders. Mm-hmm. And most of us are there with our horses, including myself, which every year I have to brag, Tommie O and Marguerite are right there to push me up and put me on. But I enjoy it. I still enjoy it. But this is very nice with the Broken Arrow Riding Club under the President the man with no first name, Mr. Murdoch.
Yes, consider dad, Mr. Murdoch. Well, back to Stagecoach Production, ladies and gentlemen. The purpose of this mentorship program, as you see here, getting a little insight from both of the cowgirls, we have to focus on education and giving the local kids from different neighborhoods, whether it be Indiana or Chicago, a mean of something to do. Stagecoach Production has a small staff of folks, few with degrees, that are willing to help and educate the history of the Black Cowboys, as well as the Underground Railroad, the Tuskegee Airmen, and the fact that some of the knowledge that my staff will be able to institute to the kids will be veterans. I'm gearing Stagecoach Production, and we'll be hiring in the near future the disabled veterans, or the veterans that are not or idle and not doing anything, such as myself. If you don't move, you don't groove. So my concept for the Stagecoach Production side of it, it's to have activities, horseback riding, rodeos, education on how to tie your shoes, how to properly dress when out in the public, and a drill team. I'm also focusing on having a offbeat of what a personal mentor friend to me by the name of Jesse White. I followed his footsteps and his legacy, and this is what the cowgirls and the cowboys want to do with our kids from different neighborhoods. Marguerite is one lady that she can and have gone. Tell us about your line dancing. You do it so well.
Oh, I do country western line dance, and I've been doing it for a number of years. And, you know, we have a lot of people that participate, and it's a lot of fun, and it keeps us moving, keeps us seniors moving, you know.
We usually have to oil ourselves up when we're doing it, but out of the dances, should it be how many collective type movements or dances that there is?
Well, I mean, there's like the hardest might be what you call a four wall, a 32 count. And, you know.
I'll be breaking my back on that one.
But most of the dances, I try to do baby dances so that, you know, people can kind of catch on and follow. And there's several places around the city that still do country western dancing. You know, it's been going on for quite some time. Yeah. It's a lot of fun.
And Julia, you got any piggyback off the some of that? Because I know you.
Oh, yeah. I follow her around. I get into the country western line dancing. And she forgot to tell you that she is also one of those belly dancers.
Oh, my
you know,
goodness.
And this Julia. Coming weekend, she's going to, one of her friends is going to be dancing with a snake, a live snake. It's going to be nice. But I love it. I love the costumes that she wears. And I just enjoy being there, tagging along. You can call me Cowgirl Tag Along because I'm right there.
Hey, Tommie O, we used to have a saloon, a place where we used to gather.
Yeah, we're gonna bring that saloon back, Marguerite. It'll be a way of the Wild West town. If I haven't mentioned to our audience, Stagecoach Production in the near future, hopefully within 2 years, we'll have a state-of-the-art Wild West town where we can have different entertainers do different things. I like to bring some of the R&B groups to the town just for a showing where the kids will probably get to see, or if now they grow up, you know, they grow up fast, haven't seen groups like the Temptations, understand that Marshall Thompson from the Shylights is retiring. So if I can bring some of that and have a couple of guys get on the horse, I'm pretty sure y'all would walk the horse up to them and do a little entourage thing, and maybe they'll be able to what you think about that? Get on the horse and come to the stage. You think we can do that?
Sure we can. I'd also like to mention that Marguerite here is one of my best friends. She also owns her own ranch. We can be line dancing. She rushes home, feeds the horses, water the horses. I'll say, Marguerite, I need to go someplace. Julia, did you practice riding today? Well, come on, I'm going to go out with you. There she is, and somebody maybe that I don't know, and they're booting me up on the horse with the ladder. But what I'm trying to say is, I don't know, the work of a cowgirl is never ending, but it's a lot of fun. She's there, you know, beating her horses after doing a long day of line dancing and everything. She just retired, and I'm enjoying myself hanging around with her. And you too, Tommie O, because I remember one time we were going to a couple of the alderman's office with the horses, and the little girl thought it was a giraffe, and she fell out, and we had to stop and start training her that it was horses that we're bringing. So we do a lot of things. We go to support the aldermans. We do parades, the Thanksgiving Day Parade, the Back to School Day Parade, Veterans Day Parade, and there's a group of us, the different clubs like the International Horsemen's, the Buffalo Soldiers, the Regulators, what was Smoking Dale's club name?
International Horsemen's?
No, they were the Illinois Pride. Oh. It's a mixture of cowboys and cowgirls that in the horses. I need to mention Valerie O'Neill, one of our horse girls, you know.
Oh, yes.
They retired, and she was one of our first black cowgirls, one of the first black female engineers. So maybe we bring her on soon.
Okay. Are we going to, this year around, are we going to have the Illinois Horsemen League and the Christmas parade that you
I couldn't get you all to take it over, so I don't want the insurance under my name, people. So if we get one of the other clubs to take that parade over, fine. They're still waiting for us.
One of the most exciting parades that come to Chicago every year to our audience is seeing the cowgirls from different organizations, Illinois International Horsemen's League. It's downtown. So you get a chance to come out this year. Please do come downtown for the fabulous Christmas parade. This will be
Thanksgiving Day
parade, but not on Christmas Day, be on Thanksgiving Day.
Yeah.
And back to Marguerite. Marguerite was holding parties, wasn't she, at one of the ranches? What ranch would that be?
Debbie. Give Debbie a prize.
Oh, yes. Really I used to host trail
rides. But we don't want
rides.
Her to stop, though.
Yeah. Oh, no. But give
Debbie
a prize.
I used to host trail rides a while back. It would be 300 or 400 people that would come out. We would have hay rides, and sometimes I would have local vets talk about equine medications and ways to treat horses for different illnesses. We would, of course, have line dancing. And we usually would have a band. So
and
I used to host
food.
That every year until my kids graduated from high school. And then I couldn't do it anymore. But maybe, you know, we might bring that back.
Future.
But it was a great time, and everybody got together. It was people from all over, you know. Some knew about horses, and some didn't know about horsemanship. But it was a great time for everybody to come out and learn.
Tommie, could we announce what type of horses we have?
Yeah, we...
You have what kind?
The horses I now own will be a Tobiano paint and a roan mare named Josie.
Okay.
The Tobiano paint is
Cherokee. How many hands?
Hands on the Josie would be quite about 16.
Okay.
And explain to the public what you mean by hands.
Okay, very good. When you measure something with the common tape ruler, most carpenters and most folks would use a yardstick. As she's saying, hands is considered from the hoof to the wither of the horse. That is measured in either or a ruler or a stick type ruler is what we consider hands. Cherokee is 15-1. That's how a horse can be measured or determined how tall that horse is. Am I correct?
Yeah.
Did I explain that right?
Hands all the way from the ground up. Hands.
So there is a demonstration from yours truly, Miss Marguerite, on how the horse is measured. Didn't I fall off my horse one time, a couple of times?
More than once.
More than once.
Yes.
That was the most funniest thing in the world.
I know.
The Thurl Ladin Spectacular Rodeo, Chicago Amphitheater. How about that?
Yes.
I'll never forget that one.
We won't.
So that's some of the things that the cowgirls and cowboys do get involved with when we put on something for the neighborhood and the folks to come out and see. Anybody want to elaborate on the rodeo we just had that's coming back next year in Lynnwood?
That was really nice.
That was
nice.
Wonderful. Yeah. It was the first time event.
I thought so.
One of our former football players, Rob Hughes, was the coordinator for that rodeo. And we've known him since he was a little guy, you know.
I'm always late, ain't I, ladies?
Yeah, it was really nice.
I try to be prompt on time, though, because I remember coming to Marguerite's cookout. I come and ain't no food left for me. Marguerite, where's all the food?
Because you were always late.
Yes,
I'm always late. So I'm trying to do better, folks. Really trying to do better. So we covered the. Oh, we want to pay tribute to one of the gentlemen that's just passed, by the way, that took an interest in Stagecoach production because it became a mentorship program, and that's Mr. Phil Jackson. We want to pray for a gentleman that worked so hard and I had a pleasure to meet and talk to and engage with while working for Chicago Housing Authority. It's gonna be sad that another icon has left and certainly, you know, we'll be seeing our Lord Jesus Christ. Had any interaction with
yes,
Mr. Phil Jackson?
Yes, Phil was the karate teacher for my daughter and my oldest daughter, the 45-year-old, then my little son, Jared and Tiffany. And
my son, Jared.
They were very good at it. That's all. I don't know what kind of belts they were, but he was very, just excellent. Kung Fu. It was in Kung Fu.
So what kids, between the Stagecoach Production Mentorship, the Phil Jackson, the Paul Hall, you mentioned my favorite guy besides Aaron. What kids have we brought up that followed in our footsteps?
Ian Stallworth. Yeah, that would
very
be one.
Very good. Uh-huh. Jared.
Mm-hmm. Jared. Jared, our little Jared, mm-hmm. little former Buffalo soldier that is really in the
what
military
What did Jared
now.
End up at now? Following me,
Freeport,
Dad.
Illinois.
Oh, say we that have again. A young bull rider now.
Oh, yes, my other son.
Yes.
We have a young bull rider that just finished professional bull riding school.
Yep.
Yeah, and he's now on the circuit learning and working his way into the rodeos and, you know, trying to get recognition as a pro rider.
Music.
Indeed.
Okay, that concludes.
I'd like to say one thing. The ending of our show, there's never been a horse that can't be rode, never been a rider that can't be thrown, that came from spirit. So I'm just telling you, keep on riding, Tommie O, and keep on falling.
That's for sure.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay.
Keep going.
We're coming to a little bit of the end of this segment, ladies and gentlemen. And I want to say hee-haw to everybody out there. Merry Christmas and happy Thanksgiving.
Again before Christmas.
To the future little ones and the ones that want to be cowboys or cowgirls. Thank you very much. A little bit more, my guy Jared, son.
Yeah,
he followed.
In the military.
Now, what did he do now?
He's in the military.
follow, yeah, ain't that something? And then we got here.